In this video, I will show you how to expand StrategyQuant with additional building blocks without any programming knowledge. You can then use these blocks in the builder or in custom groups, as I showed you in previous videos. Let's get started. Switch to Algo Wizard and click on Custom Blocks in the lower left corner. Similar to Random Group, you will see the Custom Blocks tab right next to it. The controls are identical here. There are buttons for adding blocks, importing, exporting, changing categories, or deleting. You can also filter custom blocks for Algo Cloud or standard blocks, or you can filter only certain categories here. In this video, I will show you a clear example of a simple condition called three soldiers, otherwise known as three rising candles or three falling candles. Then I will show you another indicator, concretely Hall moving average, for defining an up or down trend. So I'll start by creating the first block and start with three soldiers, which I will label 3C and choose the name, for example, 3C long. I recommend always labeling custom blocks or even random groups in some kind of syntax so that you can easily find your way around later. I choose 3C long, or I could just as easily choose 3C up, but for illustrative purposes, it doesn't really matter. And I select block type condition. I will create also a category right away. I click on the name and select the custom trend. I rename the category right away, and now I will continue adding conditions. I set 3C short, set the condition again, copy this name and paste it. Here I will change the category to trend custom and define the opposite condition. So for long, I set short. And for short, the opposite condition will be long. I start by defining the 3C long condition. I click on the condition and select a specific block. I click on close and I select close 1 is greater than close 2. Close 2 is greater than close 3. And close 3 is greater than close 4. Because I have defined the first condition for long, I can just click and StrategyQuant will automatically create the opposite condition for short. Now I will add another condition based on one variable and specific indicator. For example, I select hull up. Again, I'm selecting condition. Here I select the trend custom category. And And also right away, I select held down. Selecting the category. Define the short condition again, which I will select from the existing one, and select held down. I'll start with long again. So we are starting by close, where close is greater than held moving average. Choose confirm. And if you want to define certain parameters in the custom block, you can do so by adding add parameter. So I select add parameter and name it period. Now save it. And here there is one important thing, because this is one decimal place, we have to select int. But if you were using two decimal places here for some indicators or coefficients, for example, you would have to select double. So since I'm using whole numbers here, I select int and set the minimum parameter to, let's say, 5, with a maximum step of 100 and with a single step of 5. Now I have to assign this variable, because I have actually defined a variable with this. And if I want these ranges to be used in this block, I click on the indicator, click on the three dots, and select period. This assigns the period variable to whole moving average. These ranges will then be used during generating. Now let's show how to do the opposite condition again. I click on the given condition. And since I already have the up condition defined, I simply click on negate from opposite block. And StrategyQuant will automatically fill in or replace the given condition for me. So I have added a condition by this. Let's see where we can find these conditions in the builder among the custom blocks. As you can see, a separate group has been created here directly in signals or predefined signals. And there is a trend custom category. So if you add any other blocks here to this category, you will see them right here. And if you then want to use these conditions, just click on the specific group or specific conditions. So as you can see, expanding StrategyQuant with your own custom blocks is not complicated at all. Let's take a look at how to test a given custom block directly in StrategyQuant now. I click on new strategy, create basic symbol. Now I click on add first condition, custom blocks, 3C, and select 3C short instead. I set simple exits. For example, I choose 800. 300, and then 200 and 200. We do the same for short. I set up a backtest for CFD index, for example, Robo Forex, and click on H1. Select exit on Friday. Let's choose 21. Select store chart data to see the results. And I leave the money management as it is and select run quick backtest. I can see that the condition based solely on the price pattern of three falling candles is profitable. Of course, there is a lot of room for improvement, but it is a very good sign when the condition itself shows positive results, meaning that it is profitable. And if I try, for example, the HAL moving average and click on HAL up again, I set the default period, for example, 24, so that it is for the last 24 candles or 24 hours, since we are on an hourly time frame. Select the period for short. And click on backtest. And you can see that the HAL moving average condition itself is also profitable. In this way, you can expand StrategyQuant and improve individual blocks. In the same way, you could assign these custom blocks to specific random groups and thus streamline the entire structure. This way, you are basically able to create your own framework of conditions that will search based on your specific ideas. The entire structure will thus become faster, simpler, and more robust because you have conditioned based on your specific thoughts and ideas. Well, and that's it for today. If you have any questions, please write them in the comments, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.